I don't keep many things. It's only the things that I have are just happen to stay around. This is the stuff that's made it. This thing was handed to me by a random individual. I was playing at a place called King's Pub in Waikiki, which is this like just dungeon of a bar underneath this very old hotel that you go in. There's a pool table on the right, and way in the back was where I would play. This place used to get flooded, so all night our feet would be wet. And like, you know, so me and the bartender sometimes were the only people in there, and I was playing like 3-hour sets in there, and it was just us. But anyways, one night I was playing in there, and I come outside, and I'm taking my break, and this guy comes up to me, and he's like, "Hey, man," and he goes like this, and he goes, "This thing doesn't fit in your tip jar," like that. I'm like, "Oh, I'm laughing. Oh, yeah, okay." And he's like, no, seriously, this is yours, man. It's sitting in my house for the last I don't know how many years, and I never pick it up, and you just inspire me, man, and I just want to give this to you. Here you go." And I'm like, "What?" And I'm just blown away, you know? I'm like looking at this thing, I mean, and it's heavy, you know? And I'm like, "I don't know, man, this isn't like any rinky-dinky banjo, you know?" I took it home, I look it up, thing's worth like $950. It's like an Irish tenor, and it's one of the good ones, you know? And I was tripping out, and it had its original strings on it, but it was really old. So what I did was, instead of getting a new set of this kind of banjo strings, I just got some acoustic guitar strings and I put it on there. I put the bottom four of acoustic guitar strings on it, and then I tuned it to what I liked. What I liked this thing for was like a spooky kind of sound. That kind of stuff. So I started writing stuff like that on it. And, you know, it ended up starting to be a big part of my set after a while. Like, people would start requesting that song, and I would always give that guy props at my shows and be like, but I still to this day don't know who he is. I think his name was Eric. And only one other time in my life, like years down the line, he came out of some crevice and was like, "Hey, dude, remember me? I'm the banjo guy." I'm like, "What? What's up, dude? I talk about you on stage all the time." And he's like, "Right on." And he disappeared, and I never saw him again. This is like the strangest thing. So yeah, one of the songs I like playing on is one of my songs called Glass Castle. It goes like this. Oh, really? It's been a while. Here it goes.
He said I had nowhere to go. I sat there just thinking and pondering, so what could let me down such a lonely road? Just then I saw it. Volkswagen van, and behind the wheel was a stark, raving beast of a man. Took me to a castle that was made out of glass. We turned in. His Highness was me. said, man, I am you. I am all that you could be if only you knew. I said, what should I know? He said, come close. I leaned in to speak. And just then I woke up at home.
Mini version, rockin' banjo, bro.